Typhoon Quinta leaving a trail of destruction in several Philippine provinces. One of the hardest hit, the province of Oriental Mindoro, where Quinta made landfall Monday morning. The storm downed power lines and trees and destroyed structures. Over 1,000 families were forced to leave their homes after water in two rivers overflowed.
The devastation is really so huge, particularly on the houses, dilapidated houses, roofing, public infrastructures like gymnasiums, classrooms, roads, bridges. Our agricultural land is so much affected. Mm. It is already harvest season, but now we are suffering.
In the neighboring island of Marinduque, where Quinta also made landfall, the situation is no different. Some roads were impassable and landslides were also recorded. Heavy rainfall also gripped the southern part of the Philippines' biggest island, Luzon. Dozens of families in Batangas province are staying in evacuation centers. But the threat of COVID-19 has made the situation trickier, as only one family is allowed per room unlike before in compliance with safety protocols.
Yun nga hong COVID, ay baka ho magkaroon ho ng, imbis na ho wala kaming sakit, ay baka ho magkaroon ho kami. Doon ho kami nahihirapan.
In the waters of the province, Coast Guard officers were able to rescue 7 of the 8 crew members from a capsized yacht Monday morning. Search operations are ongoing for the last person still missing. In a separate incident, 12 fishermen at sea failed to return to Catanduanes province Sunday at the height of the storm's onslaught. Other parts of Bicol also did not escape Quinta's wrath, including Albay, which saw chest-deep floods at the height of the typhoon. Civil defense authorities say some 30,000 families were forced to flee due to the storm. Despite the storm's onslaught, National Disaster Management authorities have yet to receive any report of fatality. But they admit a typhoon against the backdrop of a pandemic is forcing their agency to redefine their disaster response measures.
There should be health monitoring, and the people who are exhibiting even the basic symptoms of the disease should be isolated from the general population to ensure that there will be no avenue of infection.
Malacanang says help is on the way for areas hit by Typhoon Quinta. These include government funds for food packs and grants for farmers whose lands were inundated by the storm. Quinta is the country's 17th storm of the year. State Weather Bureau Pag-asa expects it to leave the Philippine area of responsibility Tuesday. Dwight De Leon, ABS-CBN News.